October devotion to Mary. Why honors, prayers, and devotions to Mary? What they say to her in the Bible? Her reply and what it means to us today. Day 13. For he has regarded the low estate of his handmaiden. Luke chapter 1, verse 48. Indeed, God looks favorably upon the humble, not from any excellence in them, but from his own eternal kindness and love. Not because he is compelled to, but because their humility attracts his mercy and kindness. The littleness of Mary was not only smiled upon, but it became for her a source of great transformation and grace from God. Mary was quick to recognize this fact, that God sees the humble and contrite. He imparts his rich blessings upon them who truly need him. Yes, and truly, God is not a respecter of person, neither is he influenced in conferring favors by wealth, honor, or office, but he seeks the humble and blesses those who are in dire need of him. God passed by the rich and noble families of the Jewish people and pitched upon the humility of our Mother Mary. Child of God, the choice of Mary is a clear indication of mercy which seeks those who avail themselves for it. Our Blessed Mother, though sinless, was humble and considered herself like every son and daughter of Adam who has become unworthy by the fall. For her, God has looked with a distinguishing regard and wonderful condescension. She considered herself a person in the lowest station and had not the least reason to expect that anything extraordinary should arise from her. Yet God has put such honor on her condition as to make her the instrument of bringing into the world the Messiah, longed by all nations. And for this, all generations shall call her blessed and happy. Child of God, our Blessed Mother, despite her exalted position, considered her lowliness, baseness, that is, her low estate and base estate. She does not boast of her deserts, but the grace of God. By calling herself low, she disclaims all merits and ascribes to the undeserved goodness of God every occasion of boasting. She knows that out of free grace, God has chosen her, has looked upon her lowliness. Despite the angel's message and her exalted position, she did not consider herself of any account in the eyes of the world, and her estimation of herself was nothing more. Child of God, oh, how humble Mary was! Do we not see how Mary makes herself nothing and praises God alone? This was not the loud cry of pretended humility, but the plain and honest statement of that conviction which was engraved on her mind. We must imitate her in humility and run to her aid, knowing fully well how miserable we have become by the fallen state of Adam. Yes, we must remember that we have been stripped of original righteousness and clothed with rags, which has filled us with diseases from the head to toe of our feet. Truly, by our sins, our lives have become hopeless, helpless, poor, and miserable, blind and naked. God has, out of his mercy, provided a savior for us through Mother Mary, because his mercy endures forever. Let us be humble enough to appreciate this fact. If Mary, though sinless, could be so humble to ascribe the glory to God, how much more we should be who have truly sinned. Are we even humble enough to recognize the salvation God brought to us by her instrumentality? Oh, how privileged are they who honor, pray, and are devoted to Mary. Are you among those who do so? Remember the October devotion, the daily rosary and benediction. God bless you. Let us pray. Dear Jesus, make me truly humble. Grant that I may see all that you did for me and fully recognize the place and position of Mother Mary in my life. Fill me always with your grace. Amen.